Now, with iPadOS 26, we have three different ways to use our iPad. We can use it in full screen mode, where all of our apps are in full screen. This is the simplest way to use our iPad. And then we have windowed apps, which was introduced with iPadOS 26. And then we have Stage Manager. In this video, what we're going to do is we're going to focus on full screen apps. Like I said, this is the simplest way to use the iPad. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at full screen apps on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. Now, the first thing we want to do is we want to make sure that we put our iPad in full screen mode. Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go over here to our settings app. And then from here, we swipe up until we get to multitasking and gestures. Under multitasking and gestures, there's going to be three different options: full screen apps, windowed apps, and Stage Manager. What we're going to focus on right now is this full screen app. So what is this? Well, basically what this allows us to do, or what it does when we open up an app, is it opens it up in full screen. We're not going to have any split windows or anything like that. Everything is in full screen. So right now I'm in the settings app. It is in full screen. It's taken up the entire display. If I go to another app, I'm going to swipe up to get to my home screen. This is how we get to our home screen. Swipe up. If I go to another app, let's go over here to Safari. I tap on it, and it's going to open up in full screen. So everything opens up in full screen. Now, when it opens it up, I'm going to go back to my home screen here. When it opens up, what it does is it basically opens it up in a space. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my little whiteboard here, chalkboard here, and try to describe what these spaces are. So when we open up an app in full screen, it's in that space. If I open up another app, what it's going to do is it's going to put it in this space. So this could be Safari, and this could be Settings. And let's say I had a few other ones open. Maybe I have Mail open. And I have Notes open. Each one of those is in its own separate space. So what we're able to do is we're able to switch between these by swiping back and forth. But we have to be in an app. So let's go and open up an app and see what I mean. This can get a little bit tricky here. So let's see if I can describe what happens here. So I'm going to go to Safari. And now I want to go to the previous app, so I take four or five fingers. That's basically all we have to do. Just take four or five fingers, and then you just swipe over to the right, and now we're looking at my settings. I do it again. Four, five fingers, swipe. Try it again there, and now we're looking at a previous app. So when we go back over to my whiteboard, basically what we're doing is we're just moving between all these different apps, just by swiping with four or five fingers. Now, here's where it gets a little tricky. When you start working on an app, so let's say this is Mail, and this is the Settings app. When I start typing up a mail, what it's going to do is it's going to move this over to the far right. It's going to move that space over there. When you are on this last space here, you're not able to swipe back. So, as an example, let's go back over to my iPad. I'm in Safari here. I swipe over to the right, four fingers. Now I want to go back to Safari, so I'm going to swipe over to the left with four fingers. I'm back in Safari, right? That's basically how it works. But now let's go back over here to my settings, and I'm going to make a change. We're going to go to Display and Brightness. Now that I've used that app, what it basically did is it moved that Settings app over to the far right. So there is nothing over here, which means I'm not going to be able to swipe. So let's see what I mean. I've used this app. Now I'm going to try to swipe over here. Remember, that's the far right app, or the far right space. So I'm not going to be able to go to the next app, because this is the last app. This is the app that I've used. So it can get a little tricky. I can swipe back and forth between my different apps here. Whoops, you can see it didn't work there. I can swipe back and forth between them, but as soon as I start using one, swipe up and down, I've used that app, it is not going to allow me to do that. So it does put them into separate spaces, but when you use an app, You're not going to be able to swipe over this way. It will not work. All right, so now we know how it works. We can easily switch between our apps. It puts them into different spaces. If you want to see all of your open apps, what you do is you just swipe up and then you slightly pause. And when you do that, swipe up, slightly pause, I can see all my spaces. So these are all of my spaces. So we can see we have settings here. We also have my files app. And I can tap on any one of these to open it up. And I can also swipe over to see all of my other open apps. So I want to go to music, tap on music, I'm in music. I swipe up and pause, I'm looking at all my open apps. I want to go to settings, I tap on settings, I'm looking at settings. So this is an easy way to switch between your open apps. All you have to do is just swipe up and pause. You're going to see all of your different spaces, and then you tap on the app or the space that you want to work with. If you want to quit an app, let's say I wanted to quit settings, all I do is just swipe up on it, and it quits that app. Now, just so you know, when you quit an app, it does not save any changes, so you have to be a little careful with that. It's more like a force quit. Now, you may have noticed, let's go into Safari here, so I tap on it. You may have noticed across the bottom here, sometimes we get little windows. You may not know this, but Safari can open up multiple windows. Well, let's go to my home screen. I swipe up, I'm at my home screen. Now I go back into Safari and you're gonna see what I mean. I tap on it and now you're gonna see all these little windows here. So these are all different browser windows that I have open, each one taking up their own separate space. So in addition to apps taking up space, if an app supports multiple windows, it can take up their own space. So what I can do is I can tap on any one of these. So let's just tap on this one and it's gonna open up that web page. I tap on this one here, it's going to open up that web page. I want to go back to the original web page, I tap on this, and it opens up that web page. So if you want to see these windows, what you need to do is you just need to go to the home screen, and then you open up the app again, and if you have multiple windows open, you'll see them down at the bottom. You'll also see a little plus here. This allows me to open up a new window with Safari. So I could open up a new browser window, and it's going to open it up in full screen because I'm in full screen mode. And then I can easily switch between them just by tapping on these on the bottom here. So if you want to see those windows, as far as I can tell, basically all you have to do is swipe up, open it back up, and then you can see those windows there. When I'm in a window, I haven't figured out a way to actually show those windows. It shows the dock when I go up. I tap on the bottom. It doesn't do anything. I'm tapping on the bottom here. The only way that I have figured out as of right now is I swipe up and then go back, and now I can view all the open windows. So that's how we work with apps in full screen mode. Like I said, it's pretty basic, although you can see it gets a little complicated here, especially when you get into the windows here. But just know that when you're in full screen mode, what it's going to do is it's going to open up all of your apps in full screen. And each screen has its own separate, I'm going to go back into an app. Each screen has its own separate space, and you can easily switch between those spaces. You can also swipe when you're in an app. You can also swipe across with four or five fingers to go to a different space. So that's how we can easily switch between our different apps. I'm going to swipe up to go to the home screen. We do have a few different settings for this. I'm going to go back over here to my settings. And we're going to go to multitasking and gestures. And the first thing is you're going to see that we have four or five finger app switching. So basically, if this is turned on, which is turned on by default, and I recommend leaving it on, this is how you can easily swipe between your different spaces just by using four or five fingers. Just swipe all the way across and you can easily switch between there. You can also swipe across the very bottom here to do that, but I just find it's easy just using four or five fingers. We also have productivity gestures. Productivity gestures are double tap with three fingers to undo. You can also pinch and spread with three fingers to copy and paste, little things like that. So if you want to see that, all you have to do is just go into your multitasking gestures and you can see what those are. If you don't like those, you can turn those off. And then we have shake to undo. So when you do something, If you want to undo it, you can just shake your iPad. Make sure you don't drop it, but just shake your iPad and then it'll undo it. And then with full screen, we can't do this with our windowed and stage manager, but with full screen, what we are able to do is set what happens when we swipe from a corner. So when I swipe from the bottom left corner, right down here, I swipe. So actually what I should do is draw an arrow this way. I swipe this way. What it's going to do is it's going to take a screenshot. So let's go ahead and do that. I swipe and you're going to see there's my screenshot. So I just swipe from the lower left-hand corner. I'm going to delete this. When we swipe from the lower right-hand corner, what it's going to do is it's going to open up a quick note. So I swipe, and there's a quick note there. Tap on it to close it. That's basically the only window that you'll see when you're in full screen mode is that quick note. If you don't want to use that, you can turn those off. And you're going to see that you can set what they are. If I tap on them, I can set what it does. So you can also set them off individually or change what they do. And then we can also set if we want to start picture in picture automatically. So those are the different settings that we have when we're in our full screen app. So that's how we work with apps in full screen mode. Like I said, it's pretty basic. Everything opens up in a full screen. They open up in their own space, and we can easily switch between those different spaces with a 4 or 5 finger swipe. We can also see all of our open apps just by swiping up from the bottom and pausing slightly. And then you're going to see all of your open apps. You can go to any one of those open apps. We do have a few settings. Just go over to multitasking and gestures, and then you can change those settings. So that is how we work with our apps in full screen mode on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. I also have a couple of other options. I have a site called danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. This is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant as well as my classes and webinars. Now, if you don't like memberships or subscriptions, I do have another option. I have a course site, dansonlinecourses.com. This is not a membership site. You buy the course. It's a one-time purchase. And then from there, you can view all the videos within that course. As of this recording, I have one course on there, one for the iPhone. But I am going to, or as I'm creating this video here, I am creating a course for the iPad as well. And again, that is not a subscription. It is a one-time purchase. With either one of these, just know that you are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So if you become a member or you purchase a course or you do both, I do have people that do both, you are helping support a small business. Check out danstutorials.com or dansonlinecourses.com for more information. And thanks for watching.